In this video, I'm going to show you how to change your background inside a Zoom meeting here in 2023, as well as share tips and tricks to help you get the most out of Zoom virtual backgrounds. Because I can tell you there's been a lot of changes within the Zoom virtual background features. Now, before we begin, I think it's important to note that your machine, your computer, your laptop, your mobile device needs to be up to speed within the Zoom virtual background system requirements. And everything that I'm showing you in this video is inside Zoom with no third-party apps. Okay, so now we're here on the Zoom desktop client, which is the Zoom application for desktop and laptop computers. It could be that you're attending a meeting because you were invited. In that case, you would be joining a meeting through a different type of interface. And everything I'm discussing here should be available inside your account, unless it's otherwise been disabled by an account admin. So let's go ahead and jump into a new meeting. Okay, so now we're here inside the Zoom meeting. You can see my video. I'm using a pretty standard webcam. It's a Logitech C920. I'll put a link down below. And certainly you can see my workspace behind me. It's a very functional space. It gets cluttered at times, which might be a good reason as to why I want to change my background. So to get started, let's make sure our video is on, meaning you can see yourself on video like you can see me. And let's hover our mouse over to the video icon here and into this little caret menu right here. And one thing that's really neat about the new Zoom is it has a lot of built-in features right here in the main interface of Zoom, as well as selecting the virtual background options right here in the main interface without having to dive into other option setting menus. And certainly you can see here, the first one is blur my background. And this will just put this nice soft blur behind you, which can be viewed as a privacy thing to blur out anything that you don't want seen behind you, as well as provide a really neat aesthetic commonly found on like DSLR cameras that have a shallow depth of field lens on it that really kind of has that cinematic soft background feel. And that's what I really like about this filter. So definitely use it to block out anything behind you, but also use it for that cinematic aesthetic feel. So next up is choosing the virtual background, which is really nice with this menu again. And now we'll open up this settings box right here, which has our virtual background options inside. And for those of you who may be having problems with using Zoom virtual backgrounds, in this settings window for virtual backgrounds, you may have this option down here checkmarked, and it may be grayed out, meaning you can't click it. That, or maybe the video in your virtual background feed is showing items in the background. Those both are clear indications that your computer is not compatible with the Zoom virtual background features. And if this is the case for you, you will need a green screen in order to use the Zoom virtual background features. But as for the rest of you, you should have the option to enable the Zoom virtual backgrounds without a green screen, meaning you have the option to uncheck mark that box. And then up top here, we have the option for none, which is no virtual background. Again, the option for blur, which blurs the background. Zoom also provides some sample images. Some of them are still images like this. Others are stock video clip backgrounds that you can see right there that look really nice. But what's really cool about Zoom is that you actually have the ability to upload your own virtual backgrounds. And so to go ahead and upload your own Zoom background, you want to click on this plus icon in this window right here, and you can click on to add image or add video. Now, some people will not have the add video option. It just has to do with your system requirements. So go ahead and check that link again. But for the most part, most of you will have the option to add video as well as add images. Certainly you just click, you browse your computer, you select your image and you upload it. And this is an example of a custom background that I made myself. I took a stock photo, I put my logo right there on it, and now I have a branded background, which is really cool. And if you like the way these branded virtual backgrounds look, I do offer a service where I will actually design a custom virtual background and put your logo somewhere inside of it. So if you're interested in getting your own custom background, hit me up with the link in the description below. And you can really upload any type of background you want. You can see I have this cartoon office type thing here, which is kind of silly, but it's kind of fun. I also grabbed a couple video clips. I'm gonna go ahead and upload those so you can see them as well. I'm gonna click on add video. And for the most part, like an MP4 video file is what's recommended for you. So you can upload one at a time like that. All right, there you go. This is an office background. Certainly it's got people moving in the background, which is a really cool option considering I'm just sitting right here in my workspace. But it does appear behind me that people are working and walking around in their workspace. So it makes it look like the workspace is a lot bigger, makes it just look a little cooler. All right, and the next thing I want to show you is actually quite new with inside Zoom. You now have the ability right here inside Zoom to create your own virtual human avatar. Let me show you how it works. Now to get started, let's click on this menu icon here and we're going to go to Choose Avatar. And that's going to once again launch this settings window here. And here on the Avatars tab, we now have the option to create your own human avatar. Now before, you were able to add an animal head, whether it's a cat or a dog or a fox, you were able to add these avatars to your Zoom meeting. But now they have actually come out with the ability to make human avatars. And so to get started creating your own human avatar, you want to click on this plus icon right here where you can go through and choose a bunch of physical attributes for your character, from the skin, the face, the hair, different hairstyles, whether you're a male, whether you're a female, hair color, all that good stuff. When you're done, you just click done. And now you have the option of using this as one of your avatars. And if we click back to just my normal face here, I want to show you something real quick. Back into this menu here, is this menu actually has the option to show your avatar. And basically when you click this, it will show the most recent avatar, which was this one right here, which I had just created a second ago. And this right here is one I made earlier. And what's really cool is it actually follows your mouth when you speak, when you blink, your eyes blink. It only animates you from the chest up as pictured. It will not include your hands. It won't include drastic head movements if you're moving from side to side. And it pretty much keeps you in center frame here. And really, you can make as many of these as you want. I made a couple here just for testing purposes. As you can see here, you can really assume any sort of identity with these Zoom human avatars, but certainly a nice feature for those that don't want to show their face inside meetings. Now, when you first enable the virtual avatar, you'll be put on this kind of generic white background. And this white background can actually be replaced with a virtual background. So just clicking right here inside this same settings window for the tab, virtual backgrounds, and now we're inside our virtual backgrounds menu like before. And we can simply select from the list to choose our virtual background, whichever one we see fit. I don't know, this is not a bad look. I could get used to this. This next tip is going to be very beneficial for those who create content with Zoom, as well as those who make sales presentations. Whereas you can use your presentation slides as your virtual background. Let me show you how. Now for this one, we want to click this button down here for share screen. And then over here, click on advanced. And right here, we're going to use slides as virtual background. When we double tap that, it's going to ask us to upload our presentation file. And once your presentation has fully loaded, it will go ahead and launch the presentation within the share screen feature being used as a virtual background with, as you can see, your video right here down in the corner. Now we do have the option to resize my video where I can make myself bigger on screen or I can make myself smaller and actually move myself anywhere around the screen here. Where you put it and how big you make it really is going to depend on your presentation, what is actually on your slides, where you can actually fit the best without blocking anything. As you can see here, I'm kind of over top of words. So you just want to find a happy medium of where you can actually fit yourself. Again, so you're not blocking anything important on screen. And if at any time during your presentation, you want to actually take this video off, you can click down here on these little three dots at the bottom here and click on split video from slides. And that will actually remove yourself from the slide presentation. To add it back, we can simply click the dots and click on merge video and slides, and that brings you back on screen with your slides. This is definitely going to help you have more of a presence inside your presentation rather than just going through slide after slide after slide in your presentation. Now you're actually on screen with your audience, engaging them at all times so they can pay more attention to your presentation or your content. And a great place to pick up free presentation templates to use as slides is inside Canva. I'll place a link to it below. You can create great looking presentations very quickly. Just a plethora of ways to change your background right here inside Zoom. And if you're looking for more content about Zoom virtual backgrounds, you're definitely gonna wanna check out this playlist right here. We have lots of videos inside there talking about everything you need to know, troubleshooting, how to do funny backgrounds, how to do character faces, all that good stuff right there inside Zoom. So go ahead and check that out. I'll see you in the next video.